Hell yeah! How many of you were fist pumping during the Cyberdemon vs. Baron's fight in Tricks and Traps? Or the one in Doom 2's map 20? These are iconic cases of monster infighting in Doom. Just sit back, open a can of boomer juice, and watch the baddies tear each other apart. In this video, we will discuss what exactly triggers monster infighting, its mechanics, quirks, and how to use it to your advantage. Initiating a monster infight doesn't sound too difficult on paper. Let one demon hurt another demon, and it's world star time. But there's more to it. Which monsters can hurt each other exactly? Demons of the same type that hurl projectiles cannot hurt each other. Contrary to popular belief, it's not the projectile that determines whether the target is immune or not. The game checks who threw the projectile and compares it to who got hit by it. If they're both the same demon, then don't do damage. What about Hell Knights and Barons? Technically speaking, they're two different demons that happen to share the same projectile. If it weren't for the special exception in the code, they would have been able to hurt each other. Now let's check out the hit scanners. All of them can harm each other, even if they are of the same type. Zombie men can hurt other zombie men, same with shotgunners, chain gunners, and even spider demons. Then there's one more type of attack that doesn't check for special immunities, and that's the Lost Souls charge attack. This attack can damage anyone, also other Lost Souls. Melee attacks will never mistakenly initiate infighting since it's a simple distance check between the monster and the monster's target. It's not a short hitscan attack like Pinky's had in older Doom versions, which, fun fact, did actually cause infighting. But there's still a way to make projectile hurling demons infight each other through explosive barrels. When a barrel is damaged and doesn't explode, it remembers who inflicted the damage. If it explodes in a single hit, it does not remember anything. Let's say Baron A's fireball hits a barrel and it doesn't explode. Then Baron B gets close to the barrel and it explodes. The game deals damage to Baron B, then checks who inflicted the damage. In this case, it was the barrel, so it checks again who caused the barrel to explode. The barrel only remembers the non-lethal hit, which was caused by Baron A. This is clearly an oversight, but Baron B is now going after Baron A. The Barons cannot hurt each other with projectiles, but eventually one will get close enough to land a melee attack. Melee attacks do not check for immunities, so they will claw each other apart. This will work with any projectile hurling demon. Even Mancubi will infight, and since they lack a melee attack, they will fight indefinitely. In all the Doom versions, there was an even more interesting phenomenon regarding barrel explosions. Prior to version 1.5, the game didn't check if the barrel inflictor was caused by the same demon. If a demon damaged a barrel, then got hurt by the same barrel exploding, it would start tearing itself apart. So that's everything about how monsters can or cannot hurt each other. Although, when a demon hurts another demon, it does not always guarantee an infight. Let's analyze when exactly monsters decide to infight or not. So when will a monster switch targets when hit by other demons? When they're idle and get hit, they will immediately go after the inflictor. There's one tiny exception if an archfoe is the inflictor. Monsters will never retaliate against the archie, as this behavior is hard-coded in the game. Another demon that will never get targeted is the Pain Elemental. Its projectiles are Lost Souls, who are the inflictors. So what happens when a demon kills another demon? Depends what happened prior to the infight. If both demons were focused on the player before the infight, the victorious demon will continue the pursuit. What happens if the victorious demon was idle before the infight? Depends. If the player made a noise after the infighting began, the demon will chase the player after killing its target. If the player didn't make a sound, and he's out of sight, the victorious demon will go back to its idle state. You may have noticed that often a demon seems to be super focused on you even when it gets damaged by other demons. Why won't it retaliate? Why does it hate you so much? This has to do with the targeting threshold. Each monster has its own threshold that decides when it's time to switch targets. When a monster is idle, its threshold is always set to 0. When a monster gets damaged and the threshold is 0 or a negative number, it will be set to 100. As long as it's above 0, it won't switch targets unless the current target dies. Each step the monster sets will decrement the threshold by 1, so that after taking 100 steps, it can retaliate against other damage inflictors. It's worth noting that fast monsters will take much longer to decrement their threshold all the way to 0. This is because they barely take steps when their target is in sight. Once again, the archfoe gets special treatment. His targeting threshold is completely ignored by the game, so whenever he takes damage, he will retaliate without any hesitation. Lost Souls also behave strangely when it comes to targeting. Lost Souls can infight just fine, but only for one attack. Then they forget who they were mad at and start hunting down the player instead. That is, if the player made a noise beforehand. If no player noise was made, the Lost Soul will go dormant after charging and hitting a solid surface. So what is infighting good for? Well, mostly to conserve ammo. You can waste 50 rockets to kill these barons, or you can let the Cyberdemon kill them. Or hell, even better, make the Barons kill the Cyberdemon. Exploiting the Archfiend's lack of targeting threshold, you can cheese its Devil Magic's attack by luring an incoming projectile into the Archie. You will immediately switch targets and zap the other demon instead, and you'll be safe. Big group of hitscanners? No big deal. Let them catch a glimpse of you, hide, and listen to the carnage. Conclusion: monster infighting is good. You can save a lot of ammo, and it's fun to watch, of course. Be aware of the group of monsters you're facing, think smart, check your ammo, and on a whim, you're gonna have to decide which monsters should infight each other. And that's all. Thank you for watching. Big thank you to my lovely patrons, and an even bigger thank you to Andriy Dijklin, Cyprian Rusen, Joseph Coleman, Roman Orehov, Sean Wang, Stephen Bone, Turbine2K5. Thank you for the ongoing support. See you next time!